You must have seen that when your mother boils water in a kettle, after a while, certain smoke-like thing appears from the nozzle of the kettle, a certain vapor-like thing. Also, when your mother puts water in the ice tray and puts it in the freezer, if you notice it after a while, you will find that the liquid water has become solid. Now, this vapor is known as steam, which you see coming out as some sort of a smoky thing, and this solid is known as ice. Now, it is evident that both of them are water. So, why do you think they are so different from one another? They are different because they are different states of water. In the solid state, water is known as ice. In the liquid state, the water that we have is known as water. And in the gaseous state, water is known as steam. So, when water is being heated, it changed from liquid to gas. And when it was put in the freezer, it changed from liquid to ice. Now, we are going to talk about this change of state in greater details. So, how can we define change of state? Change of state can be defined as the change of a substance from one physical state to another. And this is known as change of state. So, earlier when we considered water changing into water vapor or steam, or water changing into ice, change of state was occurring in each of those cases. So now we are going to study each of them in greater detail. Let us perform a very simple experiment. If you take a number of ice cubes in your hand during the summer, when you're feeling very hot and you want to use these ice cubes to feel cool, what do you see? You will find that after a while, these ice cubes melt and become water. So a change of state is taking place. Let us find out how it is taking place. Initially, when you have kept ice in your hand, it is absorbing heat energy or getting heat energy from the surroundings as well as from your body. So the moment it gets heat energy, as a result, what happens? As a result, the temperature of ice increases. So due to this increase in temperature of ice, the kinetic energy of the ice particles increases. Why? Because the kinetic energy is directly dependent on temperature. So the moment kinetic energy of the particles increases, what do you think will happen? The velocity of vibration of these ice particles will increase. Thus, the speed of the particles increases. As a result of this, the interparticle distance in between the particles will increase, because due to an increased speed, the particles will want to move away far from one another. So this means that the interparticle space of ice increases. Now, when the spacing in between particles increases, the attractive force will decrease, because this attractive force is inversely proportional to the distance in between the particles. Thus, the interparticle attractive force decreases. As a result of this, it expands. Or in other words, ice expands and is turned into water. So this is how ice is converted into water. This process of conversion of a solid into a liquid is known as melting. So how can we define melting? Melting is defined as the point at atmospheric pressure when melting occurs. So this point when melting occurs is known as the melting point of the solid. And in the previous case, we had considered ice melting into water. So the point at which ice melts into water is known as the melting point of ice. And the melting point of ice is 0 degrees Celsius. So now we consider the reverse. What was happening when your mother kept water in the ice tray and put it in the freezer? If after a while you took out the ice tray, you would have found that the water had converted to ice, that is from liquid to solid. So let us see how this conversion is taking place. When water is being put into the freezer, it is releasing or giving out heat energy to the surroundings, that is within the freezer. So as a result, what is happening? As a result of this, the temperature is decreasing. So as a direct consequence of the decrease in temperature, the kinetic energy of the particles of water decreases. So due to this, the velocity of the water particles will decrease. Why? Because the kinetic energy and velocity of particles are directly dependent on one another. So the speed of the particles will decrease. Now the moment this happens, the particles will come close to one another. So the interparticle distance in between the particles will decrease. Now the moment interparticle space of water particles decreases, the attractive force in between the particles will increase. Because as I mentioned previously, the attractive force is inversely proportional to the distance in between the particles. Thus, the interparticle attractive force increases. So as a result of this, water contracts. And due to this contraction, water gets finally converted into ice. So this process by which liquid is converted into solid is known as freezing. So how can we define the freezing point? The point at atmospheric pressure when freezing occurs is known as freezing point of the liquid. So in the previous case, we had considered water freezing to ice. The point at which water freezes to ice is known as the freezing point of water. And that temperature is 0 degrees Celsius. Now we consider a third scenario. In this scenario, water is being converted into steam or water vapor. Now, as I mentioned, you must have noticed when your mother heats water in a kettle, it gets converted to steam. So now we are going to find out how this happens. So when water is being heated, it is getting or absorbing heat energy. As a result of this, the temperature of the water particles are increasing, due to which the kinetic energy of the particles of water are also increasing, because it is directly dependent on the temperature. Now also, since the kinetic energy is directly dependent on the speed, due to an increase in kinetic energy, the speed of the particles will also increase. Now due to an increase in the speed of the particles, they will try to move apart from one another. That is, the molecules or the particles in water will try to move apart from one another. Due to this, the interparticle space of water molecules will increase. This will result in a decrease in the interparticle attraction force. So when the distance increases, the attraction force decreases. So what will happen? Water will expand, and this is how, due to this expansion, water gets converted into steam. Thus, water is converted into steam due to the expansion. So this process, where a liquid is converted into gas, is known as vaporization or boiling. So what is the boiling point? The fixed temperature at which a liquid changes into gas at atmospheric pressure is known as the boiling point of the liquid. So in the previous case, we had considered that water after boiling was changing into steam. So water vaporizes to steam, or water starts boiling at a temperature of 100 degrees Celsius. Now we consider the final scenario. Over here, you will find that gas is changing into liquid. Now let us consider a very simple scenario. If you have a hot kettle like this, you will notice that when you keep a cold plate directly above the nozzle of the kettle, after a while you will be able to see water droplets forming on the bottom of the plate. Now why do you think this is happening? We will soon find out. So in this case, the vapor that is hitting the cold plate is giving out heat energy, or it is releasing heat energy. As a result, what is happening? The temperature of vapor is decreasing. In other words, we can say that the kinetic energy of the particles of vapor is decreasing. So this leads to a decrease in the speed or vibration of the vapor particles. So the speed of the particles decreases. This leads to an interparticle space decreasing. Why? Because the speed has decreased, so the interparticle space of the vapor molecules will also decrease. As a result of this, the interparticle attraction force will increase because the particles come close to one another. So this is why vapor will start contracting before it liquefies into water. So this process is when a gas was being converted into liquid, and this is known as condensation. So how can we define condensation point? The fixed temperature at which condensation of a gas occurs at atmospheric pressure is known as the condensation point of gas. Now in the previous case, we had considered that steam was being condensed into water. So that temperature at which steam condenses into water is 100 degrees Celsius. So we learned about four changes of state. We learned that when water or any liquid changes into solid, it is known as freezing. When a solid changes into liquid, it is known as melting. When a liquid changes into gas, it is known as vaporization or boiling. And when a gas is changed to liquid, it is known as condensation.